mics can pick you up.
We are live.
We're live. We got new microphones. They're beautiful.
True. 24 karat underneath. Oh, they're going to pick that up crisp.
Yeah, I was playing video games earlier.
I'm good right here then.
You're great right there.
I'm probably too close.
Fantastic.
Nah, there's no such thing as too close. We can make people quieter.
Yeah. What
which
episode is this?
Episode 26.
It just got lighter.
No, yeah. I knew what number it was. I went over it before.
Nobody told me about that. Why was that?
She did not agree to this.
We went from earlier hosting the Southside Collection Freak Down to now it's just all the lights are on. This is like a shame party after the said fact.
Yeah, I thought we were doing the After Dark episode.
This is the light episode. Later. It comes after the After Dark episode.
I'll start getting excited now.
It's when the Molly starts kicking in. And I'm still awake at 7 a.m. and the sun's coming up.
Why am I awake? Why do I love this shitty music?
It's the drugs.
Why am I touching this stranger I've never met?
Oh, y'all met.
I think that's a big... I don't want to get into it too harshly. I think that's a big part of why there's a male fan base for that.
For Molly?
Yeah.
Well,
for Molly and EDM concerts.
EDM music.
I met some people that truly do love the music.
I can't justify it a lot. Like,
what are you getting at? Like, that it gives them an excuse to touch somebody else they've never got to touch?
It happens.
I think it's the male or female persuasion. I think what it does is it loosens inhibitions that are like confidence problems you may already have. And so, like, you're both on Molly.
By
no means.
My beer on the new mic.
Look, what I'm not condoning here is to use drugs to make things easier.
Yeah.
But
however,
I see your point.
I think it's like it's a both
it's
sides.
It's a barrier breaker.
Yeah. There you go. It's like what alcohol does, but you know it.
But you can't make a podcast around Molly. Imagine we were all just sitting here taking Molly, trying to talk about
it.
We'd just be breaking ice left and right. You know what I mean?
Doug Benson beat us to the marijuana one.
Yeah, he does the whole thing.
For that to happen, we'd have to smoke marijuana. Like, why would we do that, right? Future advertisers?
Drugs are bad.
Okay, I'm okay.
That kid's what I'm talking
hell,
about.
Hell, it was a good week for Houston. Like, last weekend we talked about it. David had a fight. Derek had a fight.
So we found out when it comes to fighting, we can talk about things like that. But the Texans?
Yeah.
No, like, I've had friends of mine that, one, I didn't know they even watched the show. But second of all,
I didn't know
they
had friends.
There's part three. But no, they come up to me and they're like, you're not allowed to talk about the Texans season anymore. And like, we were like 3 for 3 weeks in a row hurting people.
Yeah.
JJ Watt, Brian Cushing, and
Brock
Osweiler.
Brian Cushing's
career.
Healthy. He's looking great.
Dead.
So you're the reason why all these things happen.
Yeah.
I grew up very superstitious, so I do believe that.
I grew up a Broncos fan, so I didn't really care.
Last time I went to a Texans game, it was tickets that were given to me, and they were pretty badass seats.
Yeah.
Got in the end zone, like row J or something.
Yeah.
And we were running a little bit late because we didn't feel like dealing with traffic. And we also ran into some buddies that we knew in the tailgating and whatnot. So we get there like... few minutes into the first quarter, and right, like maybe halfway into the first quarter, we sit down, and you can tell these guys around us, they have season tickets.
Yeah.
We sit down, and literally, like, right in the same 10 minutes after we sit down, the Texans score twice.
Yeah.
They end up winning the game, but this old man, the superstitious old guy, was just like, you need to show up late all the time.
Oh, God.
This is what is happening. You didn't show up late.
It had nothing to do with game plan.
Stop it.
Nothing to do with that. We showed up late, and then the Texans scored twice, like, immediately. So apparently we were the good luck charm.
Yeah.
I was like, well, these tickets aren't mine every week, so.
Yeah. But we're a good luck charm for fighters.
True.
David Acosta, it went into the third round.
And, bro, then he just worked him.
Yeah, he let his hands down, and he didn't get caught, though. But
oh, dude, he was, like, looking in his face with his hands down. He's like, what are you going to do, really?
Mm-hmm.
And then just, bop, bop. I already did all the sound effects at work and sound like an idiot, so I'm not going
to... bop, bop,
bop, bop, bop, and damn. It looks like an old school comic book.
Yeah.
Onomatopoeia flying over this career.
And then Derek fought on Sunday, and boy did he... Oh, man, Travis Brown did not know what he had coming. He hits Derek early on with a body kick, and to everyone's knowledge, Derek probably has something that's broken, you know?
Yeah.
He goes into the second round, and his corner asks him, are you okay? Is anything hurt? And he said, no. Like,
no.
I'm good. And then they kept on coaching him. He wins the fight. He had to poop.
Yeah.
That's what was wrong with him.
He didn't want to boo-boo in the middle of the stage and become a meme.
Who does? Yeah. Who wants that for themselves?
Yoel Romero.
Yeah, someone has done it.
So,
But
Derek Lewis now has to move into at least the five spot, I feel like. Well, Joe Rogan said it's going to put him at the two or three.
It really depends on what happens in this Alistair Mark Hunt fight. If Hunt or Alistair loses, I can see Derek going even higher. So Mark Hunt, as I think Mark Hunt's like right behind him or right in front of him.
Dude, he's on a 6-fight win streak.
Yeah,
he couldn't be more humble about it.
Yeah,
he's like,
especially after that fight before last.
Yeah,
he was not happy with himself, and
he's
can see
like,
that he
I wanted to
on
come
it
out and call so and so out, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to sit my ass down.
Yeah,
what I like though is he said he didn't. He didn't even plan on fighting Travis Brown.
Yeah.
His coaches just caught him while he was drunk and asked if he wanted to. And he's like, yeah, I'll fight him. Fuck it. And then walked himself into a training camp pretty much and then beat the shit out of him.
He said that, who was the, whoever they had announcing that night that was in the ring with him.
Oh, yeah.
They asked, Brian Stan asked him, like, whatever you were hurt, like, what made you come back? He said, I have more heart than him. How could a guy that beats on women have more heart than me?
Yes. Yeah, he went into that fight with some gems ready to go when he won, and he killed it.
Sounds like a guy that beats a woman has no heart at all.
None.
Exactly.
Absolutely none.
That's why you got his ass beat.
Go dark there, but hey.
No, you're good. We've come out pretty loudly anti-domestic violence. And
something about hitting women. Just not for it.
Doesn't really fly with me. Yeah. You know,
this isn't
not
the
really quite my thing.
You can't just...
Yeah, this is.
I'm sorry, the what?
The honeymooners. Yeah, you can't just trivialize that. That's
to the moon, the moon, Alice.
One of these days.
Yeah.
One of these days.
Alice.
Before the Chris Brown podcast.
Chris Brown is coming out as officially crazy.
Is he?
He's like.
Oh, is that what he's pleading now?
He's
just crazy.
He's just coming out of the closet with his full craziness. Like, he made a video pretty much admitting he's that ex that, like, nobody wants.
Yeah, when you're that famous,
I'm like pretty sure his publicist was just like, embrace it.
Yeah.
We really have nowhere to go.
There's no such thing as
that
bad
direction.
Press.
Kind of just keep giving us negative
press.
Everyone's going
to
talk shit about you. Let's just exploit that. Yeah.
True. These voices we're hearing are our guests of the episode this week. Shannon.
Hi.
Brewheart Apparel.
Thanks for having me on, guys.
Yeah.
Sorry, did I talk to you soon?
No, that's exactly what we want with this new setup.
I was chilling.
This is perfect. Like, sometimes people are like, that Ricky Bobby, I don't know what to do with my hands. Like, I've got a mic in my face, but I'm going to let y'all do your thing. Like,
yeah.
Put a mic in my face, I'm just going to talk.
Yeah,
get out there, roll it. So,
and then, of course, we got DC. Yeah, you may have recognized him from his many great freestyles, where he was all over that gold graffiti.
We have Retro in here, we're just like, who is DC?
Yeah, that was
that's my brother, and we're like... Perfect.
Yeah,
like, of course,
I'm here. Yeah.
I appreciate y'all having me, man.
Nah, thank you.
And that's what she do. I was asking what she do. Apparel.
Apparel. I can't even spell apparel. Y'all heard me earlier.
Yeah. Spell it.
I can now, but you would think it has two R's or two L's or some shit.
A-P-P-A-R-E-L.
I would hope you knew how to spell it.
Right? Why should
it's
I spell
on your business card.
I didn't know what I was thinking when I created it. I should have just made some catchier name. Brewheart Apparel. I don't know why. No one really gets it. And it's funny because your Twitter handle is long, like Brewheart Apparel is. In fact, it's one letter too long for Twitter.
Yeah.
So I'm Brewheart app.
There you go.
APP, just say, there's a Brewheart app? Nope.
No
just Twitter handle.
This
but
is
the future moves.
Maybe.
There you go.
Get ready.
That's what
someone
saying
had Brewheart?
Well, yes. Actually, someone did a Brewheart. It was definitely Dutch or Nordic of some descent. It's a dead, no, not active. It's a dead, Twitter. Yeah, so like I'm Brewheart Apparel on Instagram, Brewheart Apparel on Facebook, Brewheart Apparel on Snapchat, Brewheart Apparel, all over the place. But on Twitter, I can't not be Brewheart Apparel because I would be Brewheart Apparel.
Yeah.
Like with no L.
Yeah. We're Southside Cult.
Yeah.
So I was like Brewheart app. Why not? So.
Yeah. We're going through the same problem.
You gotta roll the punches, you gotta figure shit out sometimes.
Yours is just DC, right?
I'm just DC, man. I do rep the brand, Black Nation Music, of course.
Yeah.
That's the independent label I've been under for about 5-6 years.
Okay, I got you.
It's Louisiana, where I'm from, of course. You know, travel back and forth here. Been in Houston. I love it, man. I just appreciate y'all having me. I've never been on a podcast. It's my first podcast, believe it or not.
Really?
Oh, my very first podcast.
There's an interview with you out there, though.
Oh, yeah. You know, shout out to Chrissy Woodard. That's my homegirl. She's from Shreveport.
I got you.
Matter of fact, we do a lot of stuff. But what can I say? I'm a music man, bro. Family man. Love what I do.
There we go.
Traveled out here just to do this, like with y'all, you know, because I appreciate it. I know what it is. It's really y'all.
I appreciate you coming out here, man.
Oh, yeah.
I'm trying, yeah.
You know what it is.
Hey, I saw your Twitter feed today. I was like, this was really just on a bus. One, just to come to our podcast, so that's dope. And then you're just making fun of this fucking dude sitting next to you.
I didn't know. Wait a minute. Okay, I want to see this.
It
was crazy.
What's your Twitter? What is it?
It's DC underscore THO. All right,
I'm going to find this.
Everybody, y'all, matter of fact, go follow that if y'all got Twitter.
At DC underscore THO.
Yeah.
What about Instagram and all that? You got an Instagram?
Yeah, all that's the same. All that's
nice.
The same, right?
DC, though.
But nah, bro, it was crazy. First of all, I missed the first trip here. My first little trip or whatever.
Yeah.
Fell asleep, overslept. Okay, cool.
I can resonate with that.
And, you know, in your mind, you got to play a positive. I'm like, man, it got to be something, you know, coming up. It got to be something cool. But, you know, I get on the bus, 6:50. I'm sitting next to this guy. And, you know, it's cool at first because, you know, I'm a cool guy. I don't say nothing. And he kind of covering up, you know, a little bit of the seat. We already in the small seat.
Yeah.
And he kind of covering up the seat. So I'm like, man, I'm skinny. I'm just tuck it in. You know, I'm be cool.
I'll take this out.
Is there a picture? Let me see.
Look cool. And I got to tell y'all this because you don't understand, man. I came right here for this and I'm so glad I'm here, man. I'm
looks like a Puerto Rican Neil deGrasse Tyson.
It's crazy, bro.
It's crazy. Get as comfortable as you want, bro.
Then.
You might need another beer, too.
Yeah, I'm going to need that. But look, then, look, after that, you know, it get worse. He started kind of spreading. I'm like, you know, can I have just a little space? Ooh. He gave me that. Hours. I start smelling something. I'm like, you know, I know it's not me. I actually get up.
So I know it's not me.
I go into my luggage, get my deodorant, put my deodorant on. I was like, I
just
know
a double check.
Me. Just a check. I'm good. And it gets worse.
It grew.
It gets worse.
It multiplied.
And not only that, man. He had his arm up the entire trip.
Letting
it air
out.
That's the photo I was just like, it's right here.
Because somebody tells
his arm was up.
His arm down.
And, you know, it was cool. You know, we was riding on the bus. He plugged my charger up for me, so, you know, it was respect. But at the same time, it was a crazy trip.
Yeah.
To say the least, I'd have traveled out here so many times. And for that to happen like that, I was just like, you know, I'm going to just ride this out.
I got you. How often would you say, like, you make the trip, because you say you live in Shreveport, right?
Yeah, I live in Shreveport. I'm from Shreveport.
I got you.
I've been back in Shreveport for about like 6 years, 5-6 years since 2010. I actually live in Texas.
Yeah.
About a year and a half, 2 years in Seguin. Played ball, you know what I'm saying? Actually, that's where I came from.
Okay.
Played ball all my life, so.
What school is that out? Is that TLU?
Yeah, that's TLU.
Okay, yeah.
TLU, man. Shout out to everybody at TLU right now.
Bro, they got a Tyson chicken factory right next to it.
Yeah,
got the big brand on here.
You can smell it from the campus.
I have a funny Tyson chicken story. One time I was at a store, like an HEB, right? And there was this Mexican guy selling tamales. And like you can tell, like he was like an independently owned, you know, tamale guy and he was hustling. And right next to him, there was a chicken guy. And so my buddy went with the chicken guy. And he couldn't tell until afterwards. But so he asked, like, well, what wings are the best? And the guy did not care. He's like, well, these are probably the freshest. Ended up being a Tyson's chicken. Like, everything was Tyson's chicken. Like, he was just He's like, oh, man.
I should have gone with the tamales.
Yep. And the tamales are so good.
You always go independent with
them. Absolutely.
You don't want those. Like, there's off of Shepherd over here, there's a fucking, they call themselves the Taco Stand. But it's obviously a restaurant spot. I'm like, you don't want to go in there. Like, they're putting craft singles.
They're not a taco stand.
They're wrapping craft singles in your tacos with like old bacon and calling them shits tacos.
Yeah, nothing about this is a taco stand.
When we were in New Orleans, we went to one of those places, like one of those, like it was just like a long strip of people that were cooking stuff.
I had
gator tamales out there.
Yeah,
so good.
Yep, I ate rabbit and I don't regret eating the rabbit, but as much as just ordering the rabbit. Because rabbit's as small as you now imagine it
would be. It's like you're ordering Thumper.
Yeah.
So the best thing I've had is rattlesnake. You're a rattlesnake?
No.
You about to tell us it tastes like chicken?
It tastes like chicken with more seasoning. You don't even need some chicken. You need like some ranch maybe or some honey mustard, ketchup, whatever mustard. Rattlesnake has more flavor than chicken, and it has the same consistency, and it's pretty fucking good.
Really? Yeah. How'd you wrap it? Like, fried?
I think on a po' boy.
That's what's
that. Like a po' boy.
I watched an Anthony Bourdain episode of like his OG show,
mm-hmm.
where he literally just ate at this one place where every piece of a cobra got used. Like you even had to take a shot.
Every piece.
They start by slitting it, taking the heart out, and you take a shot of the heart with like some of its blood.
I saw the same show, but it was a turtle. They use every part of the turtle.
How? What do they do with the shell?
They serve the drum. Soup. They serve the soup.
Deep fried. They serve the soup.
It's the bowl. Get it? Yeah.
That's smart.
Yeah.
I actually ran into him
the washing.
When he was here filming for his Houston episode.
Is that real or is that like...
There's an episode.
Oh, no, I know the episode exists.
No, but I ran into him. So I live in East Downtown.
Yeah.
There's this pretty shady Shell station right by my house. And it's right between a Metro PCS and the worst subway I've ever been to.
Nice.
But go in there and I'm buying something.
Yeah.
And I just see this really tan arm with just... tattoos all on his forearm, and I just look over, and he's shaking the hand of the guy behind the counter. I'm like, who is this guy?
Who is this motherfucker?
And I just turn over, and he's a tall guy. He's really tall, and I just look up, and it was like word vomit. I just look up, and I go, Anthony Bourdain. That's literally what I said. He goes, nice to meet you. I go, nice to meet you.
Anthony Bourdain.
How's it going? Like, I didn't take the photo. I didn't do, because I was kind of hungover a little bit, I think, probably.
I'm not a photo person for celebrities either. I wouldn't be.
Well, I didn't know what the... I mean, literally, like, it was word vomit. Like, I'm actually pretty... He said I see some other people like everybody else, and I wasn't trying to get a... Didn't get a photo, so, of course, no one believes me when I tell them. But it really happened.
Yeah. That's not the point of it, though. That's how I
really just
that's
looked at him, and the only thing I could think to say was his name.
It's weird, though. That's where we are socially, is that, like... Now people, you have to post that shit on Instagram or have the picture to say, I've met...
Pixar didn't happen.
Yeah, and that's such bullshit, because it's like...
It was a cool experience for me. I don't care.
Akeem Olajuwon's hands all on Eckerd's.
Who?
Akeem Olajuwon's met in Eckerd's.
Yeah.
Shit. I don't know where there's an Eckerd's anywhere anymore.
Yeah.
No, CBS bought them a long time ago.
Yeah, there we go.
I was trying to figure out what Eckerd's used to make.
The Sports Authority.
Okay.
I don't need to take pictures, bro. We just shake hands.
I even feel guilty if I'm at a show and then I record something.
I met Paul Wall 2 weeks ago on San Diego.
Nice.
Yeah, and Slim Thug, actually.
Nice.
And I was just doing some business with someone across the street at Mercy, just doing some stuff with them. And I was showing a buddy of mine that had never been down to Pell in San Diego, where all the great graffiti is.
Yeah.
And so I was walking him over to the show, and I just turned and go, oh shit, it's Paul Wall. And we just ended up walking over and saying hello. They were doing some videography for some Houston Pride stuff for it was during the week
so
of Super Bowl, the week leading up to Super Bowl. Nicest guy.
Yeah.
Oh
yeah.
So
everyone says that.
Slim Thug and I had probably had the most adult conversation ever about how he used to live at Dallas and I think right there at Dallas and Dowling or something like that. And he really misses living in East Downtown. He lives in Pearland now.
Yeah.
Schools are better for his
son.
Just
put his location on blast.
Everybody knew him.
Slim Thug lives in Pearland.
Sorry,
Slim Thug. Anyway, but he moved to Pearland because it's better schools for his son and whatnot. And I was like, wow, me and Slim Thug just having this adult conversation about real life things, you know?
Yeah.
You gotta find you gotta move even though you missed downtown because your son needs a good school. All right.
There we go.
That is about as adult of a conversation as you could have.
It's right. Like, and he's also a giant. I'm 5'3", and I literally have half of him in a photo.
Oh, yeah.
It's like when we were at that Eighth Wonder event, that Screw event, and me and Shay were just like standing off, and I see DJ Michael Watts, and I have a question, and so I flag him down, and we just sat there and we were talking, and Shay just word vomit,
Michael Watts, I like,
great. And then he walks away, we have our conversation, he walks away, and then Garrett comes back, and he missed the whole fucking thing.
I always miss out on the dope shit, like getting to meet Mike.
Typical Garrett, doing Garrett things.
I was probably
let's get into this beer though. It's not often that an apparel company brings a beer.
True,
we only does an apparel beer. Company actually has a beer.
Yeah, there we go.
Which we would love to get into.
Let's start.
Yeah,
try our beer.
Let's get it.
Where are those glasses?
Glasses.
We'll start with. This is y'all's growler, actually, right?
It is.
Explain this for the people that can't see it.
It's a very popular t-shirt as well. It's our hashtag Brew Life t-shirt, and it's typical T-Rex. He's dropped his beer and he can't get it. Hashtag Brew Life. Womp womp.
What a taster.
Great selling t-shirt.
I'll take that one.
We don't have the shirt for sale at the moment, but the growlers are for sale on the site, which is brewheartapparel.com.
$15, right?
15. Mm-hmm. Which is actually a decent price for a dollar.
I forgot you had said tasters, but now that I poured one big one, were you planning on saving any of this beer?
No, if that beer there's left, it's yours and the growler's yours too.
Oh, what?
I come here in gifts, gentlemen.
Man.
People are so nice.
I don't want
to
jump the gun.
This is the coolest front we've ever come up with to get free brewery swag and like
you
beer.
You invited me to come
shit.
And hang out, and I was happy to come on, so why not bring gifts and...
This should come as no surprise. Oh, my bad.
Talk about
it. Oh, one of those is yours.
Oh, well,
yeah.
We'll just...
So,
we'll
sure,
yeah.
Does anyone...
Anyone hasn't been on the show, let's get this glass out of here.
Right? Answer our... please answer our messages.
Just say no. Just say no.
What do you think?
I like beer, so it's like... Any different kind of beer is like, how in the hell did
they? That's like good. The first step into getting into good beers. You're like, well, why does it taste like that? Or like, why is this good?
So why does it taste like that?
Okay, so Brew of H is a red IPA.
Red IPA.
And so red IPAs aren't done very often because, honestly, they're not often done well.
Yeah.
Oh.
But the difference between, and I find that people that don't like IPAs, because IPAs are very hoppy, tend to actually gravitate towards a red IPA or like it more because you actually have a pretty even balance of malt and hops.
Yeah.
And that's what the difficult part in a red IPA is finding that happy balance between the malt and the hops.
I got
because
you.
Otherwise they end up fighting each other.
Yeah.
Because they're two very different
and that's why
people can fuck
with red IPA.
Exactly.
Red IPA
it's a little bit smoother. It doesn't have that bitter finish, but you still have that hoppiness.
Yeah.
That fresh flavor. Cascade and Columbus hops. I think Cascade hops are amazing.
Any good beer that gets put out, most of the time, and like you find out that there's Cascade hops in it, you're like, well, of course.
Absolutely. It's a favorite of mine. Mosaic's up there too.
Yeah.
But Cascade worked really well with Columbus, and it was ended up being a...
I don't know much about hops, but I usually end up loving them all.
Yeah.
I can't blame you there.
It's that that fucking Michael Che skit from his stand-up where he's like, do you love me? Maybe I love anybody. What's your favorite hop? Hops.
What's your favorite? My favorite hop is hops.
Yeah, the ones that they put in beer.
Yeah, those ones.
I can't wait till I have one that I don't like, so I can remember that one. Like, fuck that one.
Fuck that fucking hop.
Well, we went through a lot of test batches.
Yeah.
And tried out different hops.
Yeah.
And different malts and tried different things and all of anything that gives it a little bit of red coloring. It has it's natural.
Yeah.
We settled on this one and I'm very happy with it. Went out there and brewed it with them as well. So No Label Brewing Company is the collaborator. And as we were talking about previously, it's actually the swag that became a beer rather than the other way around.
Yeah.
So I've been making Brew of H shirts for 2 years. I'm used and proud. I've got a friend that opened a bar, Young U of H campus. And when he opened it, I said, let's do a collaboration.
Calhoun's, right?
Calhoun's your top, yes.
Yeah.
And that place is amazing. It's a great bar.
Oh, yeah. You can get drunk at your school. It's pretty dope. If you go to U of H,
oh, yeah?
Or if you don't go to U of H, and you're willing to drive all the way out there,
you
can get drunk there.
And then just walk home.
Yeah.
If you're a student there, absolutely. Great atmosphere. They have a bunch of great stuff going on. Awesome food.
You dropped it for the football season, right?
We dropped the beer for football season.
You've been making the swag, aren't you?
Correct.
Yeah,
for almost 2 years.
Years.
They opened in August of 2014, and I was actually there selling Brew of H when we did the soft opening in August 14.
Nice.
So that's been a thing that's been happening all along. And then No Label approached me at the end of 2015 and wanted to do a collaboration dyeing their First Street, which is their blonde ale, red for the Peach Bowl.
Okay.
And it was sold at Calhoun's and at Pink's Pizza on U of H campus,
yeah.
And the keg sold in 40 minutes.
Nice.
That's
tough. I bet, yeah.
So,
the only red beer.
It's not like...
Well, and people want a beer that's
pride.
Kind of...
Yeah.
It's good pride.
Yeah.
You know
and
I mean?
It's a good... The First Street is a great beer from them. Which
absolutely.
Is like, I don't ever try to shit on blonde ales or like say, oh, well, it's not good. But it's just sometimes there's not enough flavor there for me.
The First Street's a great blonde ale.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
The first time
I had it,
I was like, that's going to be my, like, if I'm already feeling some beers,
that's like your,
I'm
that's
resorting
like your
back
hot
to
weather
that.
Beer. Like,
yeah.
An exceptional beer that you can drink, like, six of and still be good
exactly.
And just kind of go through them because the ABV is lower enough too, you know what I mean? Like patio beer.
Exactly.
So in 2016 we sat down and we met and decided to, 6.1.
Okay, so
yeah.
It won't wreck you.
It'll wreck you.
It'll get
you.
You
can take that shit.
So we sat down and we decided to actually, let's actually brew this beer.
Yeah.
And so we spent 2016 working on that and perfecting the recipe, and we released it just in time for Cougar football season.
That is awesome.
And it's been really, really great.
Yeah.
There's been cool moments.
I remember the first game of the season against OU, and at work, it was the day that it came out, so we put it on, like, pretty, like, day of. We were like, we got to get that Brew of H on. Like, this is what it was made for. And that just made people that were already in the bar wanting to watch the game. They're like, yes.
Absolutely. That's the whole idea. It resonates with students and alumni alike. Yeah. And anyone that supports the Cougars.
Any type of Houston pride.
Right. And it's a good beer, too. Yeah. So it's not like, oh, I'm having this pride. Yeah. Here's this shitty beer I'm drinking.
Hey, you're not twisting my arm here.
That was the part that made it such a cool thing to me was watching people have it. And they weren't like, well, I'll choke this first one down, and then I'm good.
So here's, go Cougars.
Yeah, I'll keep drinking Brew of H during the game.
Last night I had 240s, and they're like, why are you drinking 240? Because the first one makes the second one taste better.
Yeah.
Well, that's science.
I think it's in their label.
Yeah. Neil deGrasse Tyson did a whole episode about it on his Netflix show.
It's a different kind of beer style too. So I also like to think that people that wouldn't necessarily try a red IPA are trying this beer style and being introduced to something new, and realizing that maybe they want it kind of introduces them into a whole different side of beer drinking, only because they tried it because they were drinking the Cougar beer, which I love that. I love when people are. I'm never going to give someone shit for not knowing enough about beer. Let's tell them about
exactly.
About beer. Let's not be a beer asshole. Let's be a beer educator.
Why be that? Like, why be that asshole?
Right. Oh, there's plenty of them. Snobs, geeks, assholes. God,
You said that there's been a lot of memorable moments already with it, right?
So that day you were talking about, the OU game, Calhoun's was actually selected previous to that to be, they were a sports center on the road.
Okay.
ESPN Sports Center on the road was there.
Nice.
And my best friend Kayla, actually, who's the GM for Calhoun's.
Shout out Kayla.
Shout out Kayla. What up, girl?
It's a dope bar you got.
And she's actually she's a part of Brewer of H as well.
Okay, cool.
That's a separate entity for our partnership. Yeah. But she was right there, dead center, at 5 in the morning when they're doing this at Calhoun's, in a Brewer of H shirt. Just right there on national television. It was fantastic.
Yeah, that's what you need.
Then ESPN came back out and filmed at Calhoun's and at the brewery.
Nice.
And it was a lead, and I can't think right now what game it was, but it was a nationally televised game on ESPN.
Yeah.
UH game, and it was a lead, and they were trying to show the support that the community has for the Cougars.
Yeah.
And it was a whole segment. So, you know, commercial ends, and it kind of leads back in, and you have the announcers talking over it.
Yeah.
Whole lead-in with Brew of H just fucking everywhere. Just
nice,
on the t-shirt, on the glasses, you had people pouring it. So it was kind of a surreal moment when the announcer was like, it's not U of H, but the Brew of H.
That's awesome.
I remember sharing it from Brewheart and going, look, Mom, we made it.
Yeah, that's that kind of investment. This is fame, bro.
It was that moment. It really was.
That's
awesome. I had my Kanye moment just for that.
Everyone should have Kanye moments at least once a week.
She got on Facebook, fuck
everyone. As soon as I like you, make them unlike you.
Right. Look, Mom, we made it. Now fuck you, Mom.
Yeah. The second U of H loses their first game, I knew they weren't shit. Just,
so it was a little helpful too, because you always have bandwagoners. Yeah. So like that first game, I mean, you had a sports center on the road. We just released Brew of H. Then they beat OU.
Yeah, we're ranked five in the nation.
Right, exactly.
Jesus.
So we had a chance. Yeah, the rest of the season was not as ideal as everyone thought it was going to be. But I'm not a bandwagoner. I'm a true fan of my wife. So.
I think what was
Tom
good
Herman
to see
out of
what got out
yeah.
of what was made of that season was well. It wasn't what everyone expected, especially going in so hot in that OU game. But even though they lost Tom Herman, you saw a lot of the players, like, buy into the culture. And
absolutely.
So, like, they were the ones that were like, nah, fuck that, we're staying. Like,
right.
Why would we leave ship? Like, we're the ones that make this team happen. Like,
and that's exactly how it should be.
Yeah.
So, actually, I might have a model pretty soon. Adrian McDonald, he was captain last year before, he plays for the Chargers now.
Yeah.
Carlos is heartbroken.
You said you had a surprise for him. I thought you were about to, like, just get me, like...
Oh, you're totally in.
I'm the face of Brew of H.
Yeah, you should see
you
like
to be a model, you're totally in.
I'm in.
Done.
Boom.
We'll set something up.
Brew of H. Okay.
So, I met him at Calhoun's, and he loved the Brew of H brand, and I think, so we have some new baseball tees we just came out with.
And I saw those on the site.
And he said, I'm totally in, let's model, let's do this.
Yeah.
So, I need to get some shots and everything, and so, he was great.
So
he's like the nicest guy in the world, too.
Yeah.
I got your card at that comedy show, too, so don't think I'm not going to, like, hit you up about this.
Wait, what?
We have your contact info.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I got
your
contact
info.
He's
got to make you make him a mom.
Yeah.
I'm totally serious when I tell you that. This isn't
just
fluff shit here.
Yeah, you're not just
I don't make promises I can't keep.
That's good.
Woman of my word.
Nice. True.
I'm going to shake on it.
Oh, that is a...
It's official. That is for all of those just listening and not watching it live.
A real handshake was just there.
Yeah, and Carlos, I have a firm business handshake, too. That wasn't any girly shit there.
Mm-hmm. Very firm.
Carlos is going to become a model. I just got Pro Tools. I'm about to become a producer / best rapper alive. Sorry, whoa. DC. Don't mean to do that to you. Just jump in the lane and... Dominated, but
jump in your lane and dominate
it. I might get you a feature.
What do you guys think of the beer?
It's really good.
I've never had it at the moment, but I've had it before and I loved it.
Well, awesome.
Yeah.
So you actually get it bars all over. DC loves it.
Yeah, I wish it was real cold though. It's good. It's good, even though it's like probably just been.
Well, I took it out of my ice purse.
It's still good though.
An ice purse, you say?
my cooler.
Good beer stands the test of temperature.
It actually does.
Yeah,
it really does. And we were talking about Intercontinental earlier, getting spicy as shit and awesome when it been from temp.
Depending on taste.
Well, depending on what you're looking for. For me, I really loved it.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah,
I think
beer stands the test of temperature.
I think beers like that are cool as shit, and I love that breweries make them like in that small batch form, and so it's like you do get to enjoy it, and like you can pair it with things.
Absolutely.
And that's what makes it great. Like. Most people aren't going to go order it, like an Intercontinental and be like, I'm on my third, bro. Like, I'm fucking loving this.
That's
beer. Yeah, and like drinking a pint glass. Like, you get 3 pints of Intercontinental. What?
You're going to. It's like.
Someone's losing their shirt in a minute.
Yeah, there you go.
So what drove you to start Brewheart?
So I've been a craft beer lover and also a home brewer for a good while, and I'm a little ahead of the curve. People actually didn't understand quite what I was doing back when I was doing it. Then, you know, a year and a half, 2 years later, they're like, oh, I totally get it.
That's such a great idea.
Yeah, I know. I told you this 3 years ago.
Right.
So Brewheart just celebrated 3 years.
Happy 3 years.
Thank you. Yeah, I kind of actually forgot for a minute. You get caught up doing stuff, and I was like, oh.
I was looking
at my watch, and now, well, shit, hey. Hey, happy 3 years. Oh, what? I should put a social media post up, then, shouldn't I?
Right, yeah.
But I wanted something. So you always have, these brewery t-shirts. Right, mm-hmm. You got these things. There's just one or the other, and while they've upped their game a little bit now, and you've got these more vintage style t-shirts, and people have upped their design game, especially when it came to women too.
Yeah,
you didn't have anything, and if it was like boxy and pink and bedazzled or something.
Yeah.
Like,
just a smaller version of the dude shirts, or like you just said bedazzled
and like the hottest cotton you've ever felt in your life.
Yeah.
And it is also like short. It's like a '90s belly shirt, but it's just. Awkward shape.
A bunch of dudes are like, I guess we gotta make shirts for chicks too.
I guess so, yeah.
That the Republican Party made shirts.
Essentially.
Yeah.
So
we
I
know what women
but
want.
I really wanted shirts that just were for any craft that you could wear to any craft brewery.
Yeah.
Or while you're home brewing or whatever that says I love craft beer, but said it in kind of a fun, relevant way.
Yeah. Not just like I love New York, but just I heart C
right.
No, yeah.
Something that's got a little bit more,
the word craft would be in the heart, and then it would say beer underneath.
Okay.
I've seen the I Hop IPA
there
one a bajillion times.
Yeah.
I don't know who makes it. If you make it, it's a great shirt. A lot of people bought it.
True.
But I wanted to do something different than you because I'm not trying to copy you. So.
It's a great shirt.
It's a great shirt.
Everyone says so.
Sorry,
but I do. I try to come up with great things. But I also want a great shirt for men as well. And so, I will say that I sacrifice a little profit margin to create a better quality shirt that not only looks good but makes someone feel good when they wear it.
Yeah,
it's good. It's got a vintage style feel. Almost all of our shirts are tri-blend.
Yeah.
If they're not tri-blend, they're poly cotton, but they're damn good poly cotton.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the long and short of it. Hurley has surfing shirts.
Yeah.
You've got to go to Academy and you find insert brand here that says I love to fish.
Yeah.
I wanted a shirt that was overall didn't necessarily had a brand on it. Because also
I
know that work in bars can't wear a brand. They can advertise a brand. It's actually against TABC. It gets pushed a little bit. But still, I didn't want something that associates with any particular brand. For example, a girlfriend of mine sells hot sauce that's made with craft beer and she does pop-ups like I do. But she doesn't want to associate with any particular brewery.
Yeah, like
so she wears Brewheart every time she works.
That's awesome.
So that was the whole idea behind it, and so I found these great different styles, and there's samples. So my other half is my guy sampler. I get samples, and he's trying on this stuff. But I've often friends in all shapes and sizes that I actually say, "Would you wear this? Let's see how this fits on this person." Because I also want people to know that Brewheart's for everybody.
I gotcha.
You can be a tiny girl wearing a little bitty tank top. You can also be full figured, and you can also be a big dude or a little dude. I want things that are gonna fit everybody.
Yeah, and I like that because craft beer is not anything that puts any, like, there's no certain person that drinks craft beer.
Yeah,
right.
Like, there might be point. Some people might. No, that's what makes that such a great idea. And like you said, you're ahead of the curve. So like, some people have this idea that craft beer, like when we had Taylor here, he's like, people have this idea that craft beer is like a boys' game, or like it's just a
bunch
of dudes.
Absolutely not. You know how many head brewers for major brewers are women?
Exactly. The Smithsonian, I think it was, just hired a historian of beer, and it's a woman. Like, it's not just for dudes. And
there are some major players in the Brewers Guild that are women.
Yeah.
And they're incredible. I think it's absolutely great. And they're also not like butch women either. They're just women.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, it's not. There's no stereotype with it. You can be any kind of woman. But you know what I'm saying, though? Like, they're not necessarily mainly women. They're just women that love beer.
Yeah.
I love beer. And it's great. And I think it's awesome. It's just, I also love wine. I also love spirits because they're all made in a craft, in an artisan manner.
Yeah.
I got you.
And it's really, really, the craft of making it is very, very awesome.
And I think that's what can connect to a lot of people is if you have the ability to respect anything that's just made with a little bit more intricacy than just, like, here's our light beer. Like you start tasting things, and like how he was saying, like he tries different beers, and it's like, how does it taste like that? Like, when you can start looking into that and then finding out how, and then like it just becomes fun.
Right.
So how's that not fun for everyone?
It should be fun for everybody. If it's not your thing, it's not your thing. But it's really neat to see someone actually immerse themselves in it and really discover something new they like.
Yeah, it'd be neat to see someone submerge themselves in it.
I might do it. You give me a pool big enough full of beer, I might submerge myself in it.
I'll do it, for sure.
There's a pool full of beer.
All right, so
move.
If you ever do that, you better call me. Let's all get together.
That's
1, 2, 3, hold your
nose. I know what we're doing with the balcony one day.
Oh, there you go.
I'm so in.
Tarping it and making it full.
I'm a complete adrenaline junkie, so I absolutely am in.
I
want to jump off the fourth story.
Really, man. You know, you go to the, what was that, the Marriott we were at last night?
We had the Texas pool?
Someone needs to base jump off that. Make that place very popular if they don't die. And then they make
Brewheart
more.
I'm listening. I'm listening.
Brewheart jumping off the Marriott.
Brewheart. Cheers!
Chug a Brew of H, you jump, and your parachute is the Brew of H logo. Or any of your other logos.
That's kind of an incredible idea. If I do it, you won't take credit, right? Oh, wait, we're live. Shit.
Nah, I'll pretend you came up with
So, that. Speaking of merch, I have some gifts.
Ew. Alright,
this is a large.
Oh.
Can do.
And that's our new one, actually, that you get over there, Carlos.
Ew.
Oh, this is a reusable friendly bag. You can use it for whatever, for beer, to do whatever. It's yours.
That's what's up. We're just going to open our gifts on there.
Please,
yeah,
there's other stickers and shit in there, too.
You are the best.
And another card, so I can definitely.
That one doesn't have my info on it. That's just that. You know.
Well, I have your card with your info.
So you said this.
I don't know.
Don't think you're getting away. Ooh,
you said
ooh.
What?
I already love this pin.
Oh, and a little pin. Yeah,
I love
pin.
This pin. I'm a sucker for pins.
So we actually make a T-shirt that's got that on it too.
Okay.
And I actually didn't have your. I was gonna bring those. I didn't have your sizes right now. Because right now we have St. Patty's Day tees. That's actually the version of that, but it's a Stormtrooper leprechaun. Little top hat on, a bow tie, he's drinking a beer.
That's awesome.
I guess I should
say that. It's a baseball team.
Garrett, I'll get you one.
Nah, man, it's all right.
What's yours say, man?
It's straight.
You showed the camera?
What does mine say?
That's pretty dope, thank you.
And there goes your pin. Goodness gracious.
I got it.
Can't take you anywhere.
Jeez.
I'm rough around the edges.
Garrett.
Look at what I've got.
Houston Brewed.
Huh. And so if you notice in the phone, that's the skyline right there, yeah.
I like that a lot.
I'm about to put this in.
You showed me that when you were here, like, just visiting us that one time. I was like, that's just smart. Like, it's something that when you see it.
Oh, and they have metal. Oh, my. What are these called? These little fucking things?
Oh, yeah, the little backs.
Great.
You would ask me that right now, and I can't think of it.
Greatly appreciated.
Pin backs.
It's a different back. I can't think of the name right now. But that's where I found those people put them on. I have to put them on like little backpacks, my laptop bag, but hats are where they tend to go, right there.
Yes, right there.
Boom.
This is what happens when two dope-ass Houston apparel brands and...
I love that you guys love merch. I love merch. And I think what you do is great.
Trust me, we've got a surprise.
So I had a shirt that said HOU Brew that I've done. I might bring it back again, but I actually modeled it after a Burton shirt, which is kind of funny that you have the Patagonia, because we went for the surfer, so he's got a ton of that stuff.
Doesn't look like anything.
Never heard of it.
I mean, never heard of it. I mean,
any pop-up shop you ever have.
It was just
inspired. I don't know anything about that.
Mine was inspired by a Burton shirt.
I don't think shit.
What'd you say?
Inspired by a Burton shirt.
There you go.
Our old camera guy, his dog's name was inspired by the brand Burton.
His name
was
Burton.
Also an alcoholic.
Was the dog?
Yeah, the dog was an alcoholic.
He drank gin.
Drank my gin, more specifically.
Wow, he's
Yeah,
he had past beer after like the second episode.
I feel like I could hang out with this dog.
He was a pretty chill dog.
Yeah, he was pretty cool.
He wore shirts. He wanted America to be trill again. It was pretty dope, honestly.
I actually told someone stay trill today. It was kind of a buddy of mine. I was just like, hey, Christian, see you later. Stay trill.
There's really less things as awkward as explaining to someone what trill means, because it's one of those things you just kind of hope everyone got it by now.
Yeah.
So, sorry, I'm just obsessing over the audio levels. We're all good here. but we'll be at a pop-up, or, like, I'll wear my Make America Trill Again shirt or hat, and someone's like, what does that mean? I'm just like, it's a Texas rap word, and it's like, do you know who Bambi is?
Start there.
Like, it just gets to a weird level of, like, okay, well, do you know what rap music is? Okay, so, well, Ja Rule and Ashanti did this thing in the early 2000s.
What?
It's Murda.
Sorry. I just had to explain what rap music is to people.
They could have dropped a beautiful album together.
True.
And they would
or Baby.
I was saying they could have had the beautiful babies together, too.
Like, you don't
that
think
chick
so?
With Ja Rule's voice.
Yeah. An album? You don't think that one would have been, like, a fucking certified platinum album?
I feel like on the white version of that,
at the time.
Baby with Ja Rule's voice.
Yeah, at the time, for sure.
You're good.
It's not like that.
No, it's not. It's
you
just
don't
raspy.
Sound like Max Mom from Always Sunny in Philadelphia.
No, I do not sound like Max Mom from Always Sunny.
Right? Speaking of joint albums, I wanted to ask, are we going to get a joint project from you and your brother at some point? I mean, Gold Graffiti could be taken as the test for that.
Gold Graffiti is that.
There you go.
But I can't really, you know,
claim it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, no, not claim it, but, you know, can't really let nothing out the bag.
Yeah. That's fair.
That's my brother, of course.
Yeah.
I'm always in Houston, so. Yeah,
so you guys see
each other. We're going to do something.
I got you.
But as of right now, man, I got, speaking of right now, I'm releasing something tomorrow.
Tomorrow, man.
Call
what?
Right now.
Yeah,
I like it.
I actually sent y'all right now, but that's my first single, man.
Okay.
As long as I've been doing this, I'm releasing my first single.
Official project, or
yeah, well, off my first official project pertaining to number original stuff.
Yeah.
Right now, it's a pretty good song. It's getting a lot of good reactions to it. Just like this beer, like I'm feeling great. Bro, all right, I want to shout out her because I'm feeling great off that one cup.
Hey,
I literally drank my sample. And then I poured up another one.
Yeah.
Hey, well, cheers. Oh, you already done.
We're good, right?
You still got some
rap from
it.
Either we don't,
right,
you have to give a little right here. We're in cheers
right
now.
A little right now.
A little set, just a little bit.
Yeah. But like,
a skeet taste.
Haha.
Cheers.
Oh,
cheers, man.
Cheers.
But yeah, like tomorrow, man.
Yeah, that'd be wild.
Cheers.
I'm going to drop something for y'all, man.
Yeah.
I appreciate y'all. My brother told me y'all was a pretty big fan, so.
Yeah,
whenever. It's my business to get out here.
Whenever I hit you up and you said, like, my brother told me y'all like me, I didn't know if y'all fucking me that hard. I'm like, what? Like,
yeah.
You literally steal a show on Gold Graffiti. That's one of the first things we asked him when he came here. Was like, who the fuck is DC?
Because
this guy is just coming out of the woodworks, just spitting.
Little brother, man.
Yeah.
Like I said, I've been doing the music for about 5-6 years, but you know, that music game itself is something serious. And I feel my antenna is bigger. Like,
okay.
I don't just, you know, put music together, of course, like she did. I'm sitting up there listening to her and what she did. Like, last year, the Cougars went crazy.
Yeah.
Like, that season, I'm a football fan. I played all sports. And I prefer college over,
really?
You know, professional.
I love college ball.
And I watched them go crazy. So, for her movement to be a part of that, that's dope.
Yeah.
And, like, I want to do the same thing with my music, my brand, Black Nation Music, you know. I got a lot of other stuff behind the scenes that I'm working on. We'll
yeah.
do that later.
I
but,
got you.
I want to be influential, man. I just don't make music to be heard or
make
to get downloads.
Yeah,
right. No, I want the bag.
But it's not.
I would cash the check.
Yeah.
I want to earn it.
Give me the check,
but
that's
like,
not why you make
it. But earning it is the most fun of all.
Yeah.
It is.
You know what I mean?
It is.
When,
most
when things pay off because you know you put work in towards it, like,
mm-hmm.
That's when shit really works out well.
Most definitely.
And when you enjoy the process of earning that.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
If you're loving what you do, there's no better feeling.
Yeah.
Yeah, like how she saw, like, you know, on the little clip, like, everybody, you know, pulling her brand up, like, I want to do the same thing, like, being out here, probably going back and looking at this video, I'm going to feel the same way, because I know, like, I'm a brand of Louisiana, I'm a brand of Black Nation Music, and I represent something, so,
yeah.
That mean a lot to me, you know what I'm saying, and
I got
just
you.
To be here a part of this, like, that's dope for
yeah.
me, and it's a lot of dope music coming out, like, I don't talk a lot, I don't really put my stuff out on the net for people to know,
yeah.
I back it up in my music, and, you know,
that's
my way
sure.
of living, you know, trying to do what I can.
You
I got
really
a lot of
do.
Shit coming out. Like, I've been really holding shit for a while.
Yeah.
And I haven't been saying that, but I'm finna drop a whole lot of stuff, man. And a shout out to everybody back home, Shreveport. I got something called The 8. And for those who rock with me, y'all know what that is. And it's just really, it's a shift in the culture because, you know, a lot of stuff, well, the world itself is kind of fucked up right now. Excuse mm-hmm. my language, so.
Nah,
I wanna be a positive.
Fuck your language.
I wanna be a positive move.
Yeah,
and something changing. You know what I'm saying? And I know I can do that. I can reach the masses by making music.
Mm-hmm.
People listen to me.
Yeah.
Working a 9-to-5, ain't nobody gonna listen to you that much.
Yeah.
You gonna get your check. So, I put stuff on wax and shit. I'm here now. Like, you know, last year I did what? Open up for a Currency.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you about
that.
That
shit was retarded. Like, never thought that. Never imagined being in front of, even though everybody was like dead stuck high, you know.
Oh yeah.
It was
where was
cool.
that at?
It was actually a Warehouse Live.
Were you there for that one?
Yeah, at Warehouse
this
Live.
Is that for my head?
Was that last year? You said.
Yeah.
Hello, East downtown.
It was what? Last year.
Mm-hmm. You weren't there.
Because Currency is always
yeah.
usually
to get
you for 420.
You to get you
yeah, it's 420.
Yeah. It's
like
420.
Yeah.
I went
420.
Well, I might have been
I
last,
don't think
I might have been
be
last concert cafe on 420, but that's kind
that
of.
That would make sense.
I love last concert cafe, though.
That's,
yeah.
They understand why, and
nice.
I promise
see,
you wouldn't be
I
mad
mean,
at me if
once they have, like, a concert going,
it's all
nice.
Good.
But absolutely.
Otherwise, but that's not
nice. Well, I wanted to catch you in some of your town.
Yeah.
That's why I met Seth.
I got to let y'all know about the next time I'm doing anything here. Like I say, I'm really just getting out as an artist.
Yeah.
I would say this is my first official year of being an artist.
Yeah.
Because I took the business part serious, you know.
Yeah.
Shout out to my CEO, Antonio Smith, aka Fido. He really was hard on me, you know, as well as my brother, about getting the business part right.
Mm-hmm. I got you.
Because I was just having fun with it, but like,
yeah.
Now since I'm more business oriented, it's more serious. I kind of carry shit with a chip on my shoulder.
We got you.
So what else besides the business would you say you learned from sitting like in the back seat this last year and watching like retro work? Because retro's been grinding too.
Be consistent.
Yeah.
You know, not only be consistent, but put out quality.
Yeah.
And don't be afraid to be yourself. Like,
yeah.
Take that chance. And I'm going to say this. If anybody's listening, if you're doing something and you
hopefully
feel like it's hard... I know it's a lot of people listening, but like, if you're serious about your craft, like, don't quit, man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Don't quit.
I agree with that. Honestly.
There's always going to be
like,
some in you that says why you should quit.
Yeah.
Every
and,
day.
Yeah.
Every
bro,
day.
It's a motherfucker. Like,
yeah.
No lie. Like, there's, when it comes to making your shirts or making your music or, like, us doing this podcast for 40
years. Yeah, we could have quit after the
do
fucking first 15.
You do and own what you do
yeah.
and keep doing it until you're successful. And if it's not successful, you
yeah.
find what's not working and you make it work, you know, if it's something you love.
The
mm-hmm.
the blissful irony of that is that there's a guy who wrote a book almost entirely about that concept where there's literally a voice in your mind that makes you say, this is why I couldn't do it, or this is why I shouldn't do it, and
yeah.
here's all the reasons that could go wrong.
What's insecurity and doubt?
And that
yeah.
was the first
yeah.
book he made that was successful out of, like, the first 12 that he wrote before that.
Wow, that's kind of
that's
ironic.
What made,
yeah,
yeah, that's what makes
yeah.
that fucking great, is his book about what
yeah.
happened to him. Pretty much. It's his mode, yeah.
Because everyone can identify with that.
Yeah.
Everybody can.
Anybody
it just matters what you do with it. You listen to that voice, or do you tell it to fuck off and you
yeah,
keep going?
Exactly.
Yeah.
You know?
So.
I feel like I'm at that point. Like, I feel like everybody here is at that point.
Yeah.
Everybody here right now. Shout out to my girl over there in the cut, Sharita. She got the film work going.
Sharita's on it, man.
Vision.
Yeah, she had the whole thing.
Sharita's
man.
On it.
You know what I'm saying? Gotta see the vision. So, I mean... I'm at that point, and not more so because of, you know, my age and, you know, getting up there, because I know what I could do.
Yeah.
I know what it takes now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And
that's
seeing it work, like, yeah, like seeing it work, like this past year, I've become a totally different artist.
Yeah.
As far as how I move, who I mess with, you know, how I plan, how I structure stuff. and seeing the progress, it's humbling, you know. Yeah. And I just want to remain humble, because I know the more I do that, the bigger the blow up, the faster.
Yeah.
But you gotta stay consistent too.
Yeah.
You know, that's what I learned last year.
I like this guy so much.
I like your beard.
Consistency,
I like your shirt.
Is
I'm
king,
gonna take
Gary's
shirt.
I need
Gary's shirt, man.
I mean, I don't want to give it, but it's like, shit, you're my guest.
Well,
and
actually,
and I'm gonna model for her. I'm gonna be all right.
I have one of those in your size downstairs.
There we go.
Boom.
It's lit.
Done.
You got another model.
So, you're.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hey, but consistency
real
is king, and I say that about anything.
Yeah.
It comes to beer, and it comes to what you do, and your values, and what you represent. Consistency is key. People
and that's a big part of why we do this show, and why our guests, like almost every episode, our guests kind of like reach a point where they realize that what they're doing is not too different from each other, even though they're doing two completely different things.
We're doing very different things, but our concept,
but the grind is the same.
The same.
Yeah.
It's the exact same.
Because everyone can resonate with the fucking hustle, if you're doing it correctly.
Exactly.
Because you can see it in everybody's certain hustle if you know how you're supposed to be doing and handling things.
So
like it also allows you to see when people are fucking up and like observe
or slacking.
And, like where people could be doing things better or different. And so
a lot of people do slack and they're finessing.
They're
finessing themselves.
Yourself. Oh, I've met a million.
Oh, is that what that is? I didn't come up with that.
That's true.
Exactly. But people do finesse
themselves. Finessing is a bunch of empty promises and nothing is done.
Exactly.
Finessing.
But they're a great time when you're having a cocktail. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It was good.
I didn't mean to get all weird there.
We
had a drink, having a good time.
We're on a good show right now.
We're just having an actual great time. Cheers.
If you're just listening, we were all raising our glasses.
And if you're watching,
and if you're watching, you saw it.
Think you're watching.
If you're watching, you saw it. Yes.
Thank you for watching.
That's
watching.
A true statement.
You haven't seen nothing yet.
So,
if you're watching, your eyeballs have seen this.
When you rap, like when Retro raps, I can hear that like Louisiana in him. When you rap, I just get like I get the South, but I get like everywhere else in the South. Man, you really have a interesting flow. Who are your influences?
My main influences. I've become my influence myself, honestly. That's not to be cocky, but I have, because I know where I started as an artist. I would say God's my first influence, because you know, he gives me that to wake up and do it. So that's my first influence.
Good morning.
As far as artists though, Three Stacks, man, that's my top artist, man. Andre 3K?
Yeah.
That dude is awesome. Who can I go to? I like Hov.
Yeah.
I like Hov.
Just a spitter.
Yeah.
Hov is intellect.
No, he doesn't. Not who.
I
know who.
I was like, Shannon,
who,
you seem pretty hip. And
I would say who doesn't. I was just kind of dragging out the
idea. Yeah, I know she likes it. You can tell she know good shit.
Are you a bigger fan of like certain artists or certain albums?
Certain artists probably.
Yeah.
I don't too much get attached to albums, because I honestly don't take that time to sit down and listen to another artist. Like growing up, I did.
Yeah.
Like I grew up like on that Blueprint.
There
like,
you go.
JC was dropping the Blueprint. Like,
yeah.
I grew up on that. I grew up. I feel like I'm also R&B influenced.
Yeah.
Like as a child, like that first Tevin Campbell, like I grew up on that, and I feel like certain stuff sticks with you because I like originality and people have got out of that with the music.
I was really hoping he was gonna say Bobby Brown.
Bobby Brown.
Bubba DeVoe.
After watching that new edition, I like Bobby Brown and like where they took the music.
Yeah.
And I might add him as an influence. No coke.
No pressure.
Pressure makes coke crack.
Yeah, it's so. It's just like having that will, man.
Sorry, I don't even know that's true. I've never cooked crack.
So I'm totally going to use that at some point in my life.
That's
pressure makes coke crack.
That's real though.
That's real though.
That's real. But anyway, I'm really not too driven by too many other artists, because it's like what I grew up on. Now, truth be told, like the Houston movement when it was like real heavy, like that Swisher House, like when Color Change and Click, like all them, I grew up on that.
See, like, I remember that. I like that music because you reference not obscure, but you reference like everything he was saying.
Man, and that goes from like Zero.
Yeah.
Honestly, I feel like Lil Kiki is probably my favorite Houston rapper.
Okay.
That's fair.
How old are you, DZ?
29.
I'm 29 also.
Well, when your birthday?
October 11th.
Oh, mine is 16. That's crazy.
October 16th?
Yeah.
What the
damn
fuck?
Damn it, I'm older than he is. I turned 30 before he does. Libras, man, Libras.
Yeah.
So I was
15.
I was a sophomore in high school, and there was this one screw shop in Katy where I was.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
At the time, on Mason Road called The Shop. T-H-A.
Mm-hmm.
Shop. The Shop.
You know what you're talking about.
And I literally bought Guess Who's Back. There's a switching house, Guess Who's Back.
Yeah.
And that was, I mean, I remember there was a Big Timer song. It was my girlfriend and I just ran.
Big Timer?
Yeah, we went to Cinco Ranch High School.
Yeah.
Yeah, Big Timers.
Oh,
yeah.
Man.
But it was not a big song. It was super popular, but it was a super popular
yeah.
with Scrooge.
At that time, yeah.
And we would listen to it. And like, we're two little white girls who go to Cinco Ranch High School. Like,
yeah.
You know, but I love all music, and I always have.
Yeah.
And we literally went to the shop and bought this CD.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then cruised around Mason Road and then finally found someone to buy
his
alcohol and go to a party.
Ranch.
Yeah.
I went to Morton Ranch
yeah.
for a little bit.
Did you really?
Yeah. And I
remember Morton Ranch was built.
I don't. I had to
I think I already graduated.
Yeah, yeah.
I
then
had
you,
my
yeah,
first
you
home
were.
Run ever in high school baseball at Morton Ranch.
Well, I'm not that connected to them. Fuck Morton Ranch. But... I forgot where we
were
getting at.
But anyway, we cruised around Mason Road in our car.
Oh, yeah,
and
yeah, yeah.
listened
yeah.
to that, and we were like the whitest girls ever.
Yeah.
Now, I've always been a pretty open person, but face value, super white girl. Just
yeah.
going
yeah.
to the shop
yeah.
and buy a Guess Who's Back album because I liked it.
Yeah, it made me feel good.
Made me feel
good.
It was fun.
Yeah.
It was fun.
That's what music is. It's
exactly.
feeling.
I used to dub all my mama tapes. Like, she'd be gone. Like, I'd be in her room, like, beating on her shit. Like, beating on the dresser, dubbing all her tapes.
Yeah.
Like, rapping.
That's fucking
what
like,
they listen to? What would your people listen to?
Like, my people?
Yeah.
Probably a little bit of everybody. Like my mom's side, the Krayshawn. That's my last name, Krayshawn.
Yeah.
It's like deep stuff. If not all of them, majority of them are music influenced, can sing, play.
Okay.
Like, I have a cousin that's a violinist that's crazy. Shout out to Josh. Man, he's just
what's
a smart.
I
really
respect
Josh
that.
Davis.
That's an instrument that kind of escapes me.
You got to
yeah,
get an instrumental
smart.
Fucking beat by him, man.
Oh, yeah. Like,
yeah,
like I said, I got a lot of stuff in work. But he's like, just to be from that
yeah.
branch of it is kind of make me feel like, okay, maybe I was supposed to do music.
Yeah.
Like, maybe this was the direction for me, so. It's just crazy, man, to be doing what I'm doing and how I'm doing it at the pace I'm doing it.
And what's the name of your next project?
Patience.
All right, so where does that come from?
Patience.
Other than, like, you showing a lot of patience getting
oh, man,
this far.
It's self-explanatory.
Yeah.
yeah.
Pretty much once they hear the tracks, they understand.
Yeah. How many tracks is that going to be?
I'll probably give them from 6 to 10 tracks, maybe.
There we go.
That's fair.
I'll give
but
them.
But it's original music.
Yeah.
It'll be on iTunes. It'll be on you know, all
you.
The outlets.
Yeah.
You
yeah.
can download them.
I
but
you.
Tomorrow I'm releasing right now. That's an original project.
Yeah.
The producer is actually from Europe.
No,
I just
you.
I just shot that video, as a matter of fact.
Okay.
I'm
so
going to release that. I shot the video out here, too.
Really?
Yeah. Shout
I
out to
you.
Gene. He shot the video.
Shout out to Gene.
Gene?
Yeah, and the producer's name is Problem.
Yeah.
And he's from Europe. I tried to invite him out here to shoot the video. And he was like, man, I wish I could make it. I was like, man, you could just come out, man. I'm be in Houston.
Yeah.
He was like, I live across the world. I was like, what?
Wait, since when?
Yeah, I was like,
our Gmail accounts for this.
And I record that track a year ago. That's crazy. Like, I never knew he did
yeah.
that. So.
That's crazy how that relationship
can make
like,
sure you send him this
yeah.
interview so you can see this shadow, man.
Right?
Yeah, yeah. I'm pretty sure he
problems out there killing shit.
He saw the video and like I'm actually the only video he posted on his page, the only artist video he posted on his page.
Damn son. Sorry, Charboy came in and just
came and caused the ruckus over here.
Charboy,
let's not get into it.
What's going on over here?
Come on, show yourself.
No,
show yourself.
Let's not get into it. So.
Nah.
yeah, I'm there a little bit.
You opened for Currency. How did you get that? How did you get that connected? Like,
especially
what was
over
the
here.
Cash, to that?
Cash, right?
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
I got you.
Like, man, that boy reached out to me. Me and Cash grew up like like youngsters.
Yeah.
Like one and two growing up.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And like we kind of branched off after high school, or maybe like going through high school, and I didn't see him for quite some time. Like,
yeah.
I probably linked up with him 3 years ago, three or four years ago. And I heard his first project, because growing up.
10K?
No, period.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm period. I'm still a fan of Pitt.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah. I got you.
And like, you know, when I first heard it, I was like, damn, pretty good. Because growing up, he used to always rap other people's shit. Like,
yeah.
We was real little. I was like, Chris, I don't know who that is. And like, to hear that,
yeah.
Like, that like motivated me. And I was already doing music at the time.
Yeah.
Like, and I became highly influenced. And like, last year, he just reached down to me, helped me with a lot of things that I wasn't polished with.
Yeah, I got you.
As an artist and as a person, so
that's cool.
It's like now, man, it's modestly speaking, it's like,
yeah.
Like we said, you reach a point where you just, it's not to be cocky, but it's like, shit.
You know you're doing shit right, so you're like, I fuck with myself.
Yeah.
Like,
I fuck with myself.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's
all about that.
That's another thing, though. It's like, so like, I feel like as an artist, you realize your stride and you're about to hit it. And then when you say, like, I didn't think y'all really fucked with me like that, I'm like, you dropped the whole. I think rappers should drop more mixtapes, so like how they used to.
Yeah.
Over some fucking radio, like some popular ass beats, some doper bars.
Yeah.
Like,
on one of the songs, you literally mention a few different things along the lines of like, one, you'll ghostwrite. Who needs a ghostwriter?
Yeah.
I need the fame.
Yeah. I ghostwrite, by the way.
Really?
if you need ghostwrite, you need a verse. Fuck with me.
There you go.
How much verse, bro? Let them know right now. Give them the inquiry. If you suck, how much? If you're good, how much?
I'm not gonna do that.
This is the delivery fee. This is the delivery fee.
I'm not gonna do that to myself, man. I'm still in those extremely humble stages. Like,
no, fuck honestly, that. People need to buy verses.
I haven't even tried for a verse. My cousin, he asked me, could he pay me for a verse? I insisted not, and he was like, no.
Yeah.
He was like, I'm paying you for a verse. That's my first pay for a verse.
Yeah.
I feel you.
So you know, it's like.
So when I started t-shirts, you know how many people came out of the woodwork and was like, hey, throw me a t-shirt. Hey, throw me a shirt, I'll totally rep it. I'm like,
yeah.
The fuck does that even mean you're going to wear around? 20 and
more people buy this
right.
Hat.
So the people, the friends of mine that said, I would know, Shannon, I'm going to go online and buy it like everybody else.
Yeah.
I'll pay the shipping. I will ship it to you. I'm going to support
yeah.
your business. That's what that is. It's all about.
That's
what it's
about.
Really let's support each other.
People.
I really did.
Because they appreciate you. Like,
yeah, exactly. If I had some more person say, hey, just throw me a shirt, I'll rep it. I'm like, what? I don't even
know. I'm more inclined to give you something
yeah.
if you've bought something.
Exactly.
No, that you actually support me.
Yeah.
What are you going to do? You're really just
give me something
shirt.
For free. Like, how does that work? How does that help
no.
me at all?
Right.
Like,
now I've done trade shows with other business.
Yeah.
Like,
if I just gave you a shirt and said, hey, thanks for seeing what we're doing. And, like, wear it. They're going to have no personal tie to it, aside from
right.
the fact that they'll see it and be like, oh, I know someone who makes that shirt. But that's,
right.
like...
I don't care how much you take her to rep it. It's going to be the same thing.
Yeah,
maybe
exactly.
there's, you know, they just got a free shirt. Okay,
yeah,
cool.
Free
someone
shirt.
Sees them wearing it. Oh, it's
that's
like,
how I see it.
Oh, it's just my friend's shirt. Like,
yeah.
I swear, like, they're not going to be
yeah.
representative for anything.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I hate that term. I'm going to rep it.
I'm going to rep it.
I don't hear that
from my music,
though.
But this is... But that's the same thing, appreciating someone that wants a verse from you and it's going to pay for it because they appreciate
yeah.
your talent and the hard work that you
yeah.
put
yeah.
forth to produce it.
Yeah.
It is hard though. Like it's hard when you're different. Because it's almost like now if you come out with the same stuff, like, you know, it'll work.
There's a formula.
Oh, yeah.
It's a formula.
And the formula shifts every once in a while.
Yeah.
But
yeah,
it's a
exactly.
formula
and
for a good
people,
while.
You see people hop right into the new, like...
Yeah. And just
shouts out to Drake for being able to just properly, continuously ride that wave just
yeah.
wherever
that
it
is
goes.
Exactly what
yeah.
Drake's doing. He's
yeah.
just riding
for
that wave.
Remember when Houston was
tight?
Remember when Houston was tight, bro?
I'm not going to lie. Like, Drake, like, when I found out about Drake, I was going to school in Houston. My
yeah.
mom was like, you should listen to this dude. Like, mainstream artists to me, like, they're good.
Yeah.
But there's so many people out there that you don't know of. So why can't we have the same opportunity?
Yeah.
You know, it's people that put you out there. I'm pretty sure it's people that's told her or put her in a position like, you know, you can't do this because you haven't done A, B, C, D.
Yeah.
And that's a lot.
Well, that's been my entire career.
You know what
yeah.
I mean? Yeah. And it's
yeah,
exactly. And like that's I've been through that shit 5 or 6 years.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And like the same process.
I was just gonna say, most of that is like, it's not you haven't done it, it's you haven't done A, B, C, and D for me.
Exactly. Yeah.
So that's why you see, like, that's a good point you make, though. Like, and I've thought that out sometimes whenever I do, like, I'm well known for, like, jokingly hating on Drake a little bit, just because it's easy.
Well, everyone remember how he was, Grassy?
Exactly.
But he got has a holiday, and he
yeah, like, the people that are mainstream and well known, they are.
I know people that bought that.
They are there for a reason. They're there for a reason, and so it's like, but they've done A, B, and C, and D for the right person.
Yeah.
To get them there. That's not saying that person was the right person, because there's, like, someone put me on to, Jamie over here put me on to Future's deal with his manager, where it's like, he owes him half of his touring fees. And so, like, it's no wonder Future charges, like, $500,000 to appear, because it's like,
he still has to make money, exactly. Otherwise, he's doing this for free, and it's ridiculous.
And this is just how weird hip-hop beef is. So, apparently, Future lost a lawsuit where he has to give up his royalties on 2 albums, and then touring for, like, the next 2 years.
Really?
What?
And he said that that's not true. But he's about to drop 2 albums real quick.
Yeah.
So, hip-hop is interesting that way. I don't know if he really... Because he said he didn't lose a lawsuit. That's not happening. But he is dropping 2 albums on the fly real quick.
I'll give it to him. That's
publicity
case,
magic right there.
Hell yeah.
Publicity-wise, he's killing it.
Yeah.
At midnight tonight, there will be a new Future album.
Yeah.
Ta-da.
Yeah.
Hurry up.
Yeah, right.
He said his most controversial.
Real quick. Ooh.
He's going to say
serious. DC, what goes into your beat selection, man? Or more specifically, on this tape coming up?
I do have some producers that I was introduced to, like, back in 2012.
Yeah.
Well, not 2012, I lied. 2013 and 14. And at that time, I was doing a lot of shows, traveling, so I have some out there. But I have a home producer by the name of Rod Beats.
Okay.
I've been working with him, yeah. Shout out my boy Rod, man. He said I'll never shout him out.
Shout out Rod Beats.
Shout out.
Yeah. And I've been working with him. He has like 2 tracks on the EP.
Okay.
But most of the time, I listen to something different.
Yeah.
You know, I listen to something upbeat.
Yeah.
Because now I'm not so much as into making something hard or making something that sound good. Like, I want to make the best shit possible.
Yeah.
Like, I want to make something I know for certain is going to go. Like, whether it be old, new, you know, whomever is influenced by something.
Yeah.
My beat selection, man, it comes from anywhere, man. I'm just, diversity is key for me.
Yeah. And the thing is, you've already proven you can spit on nearly every type of beat anyway. Like, by doing the tapes you've done, where you literally are going over other people's beats, and then, like, some of the songs you've done with Retro, where it's, like, that 99 and 2000 song.
Yeah, that's
a quick-ass beat.
That's
and,
one of my favorite songs.
Wave Runners, I think, is one of my favorite songs with y'all too.
And see, and that's like literally the complete opposite.
Yeah,
there's one that claps at you, and then there's one that's like, dun, 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 dun.
Oh, I know.
That's a horrible version
here.
Of Wave Set.
There we go.
You listen
to
DC?
Yeah, I got a
SoundCloud.
I got to put on. It, but it's.
Can I find you on Aaron?
Where can
I find you?
You can, if you have Instagram, you can follow me on Instagram.
No,
right
your
now.
Sound.
Oh yeah,
it's in the bio. It's on the bio and everything.
You actually said that earlier. Now that I realize it. Sorry, I get
DC
underscore
that.
Sometimes I apologize.
And if you want to give me an email, I'll send you a track directly. Like
there we go.
That's how I feel about my music.
We're friends now. Sorry.
Oh yeah, it's up there. Cheers.
Damn.
This boo hard is awesome. But it's like
Y'all got a new sponsor tonight. You didn't even know it.
Hello.
I'm trying to rock up shit.
Hey, DC loves Burbage, man. DC loves
it. With my shit.
This is what I love seeing happen with these episodes. Is like, two people that there's a chance y'all, one, never would have met, and two, never would have even had a reason
Absolutely.
To meet or, like, known of anything that each other does.
Turns out we're 5 days apart.
Yeah.
And we're doing the same. And we're both hustling in the same way. It's just
to do it. And then we get to do the easy thing where we're just like, let's ask some questions about why they do things.
But I love it.
Well,
that's one of the things I always bring people together. And
yeah,
I think it's really cool. Should have done it like this because you're cool as fuck.
Our birthdays are a couple days apart, too.
I'm cheers you like 6 times.
Next week's episode. Next week's episode is our birthday episode, technically.
Oh, yeah?
I'm the 3rd, he's the 5th.
Really?
All right, the episode's on the 2nd. So, we're going to have a good old time.
I've been having some shit going on.
Man, back in the day, how you gave me that look.
We did some birthday shit.
Yeah, birthday shit has been bad.
Somebody better be shotgunning a beer doing something on that.
Oh, that's for sure.
I'll do it, yeah.
I made him chug a Steel Reserve just for losing a bet one time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was gross.
Oh,
Nothing you're real until you're shot getting like a 16 ounce double IPA. So there's video proof of that on Instagram with me, by the way.
Really?
It was a 16 ounce more cowbell.
Oh, there we go.
It's a double IPA from Buff Brew.
Yeah.
Shotgunning it in the cooler at Buff Brew after like the tour was over there. We're 12-3 on Saturdays, and we were all in the cooler wearing happy fucking birthday hats for a friend's birthday, and there's like six of us.
Yeah.
And honestly, the chicks that were doing it threw it down before the guys did.
Double rodeo clown.
Oh, 16 ounce, right?
Oh, yeah, the rodeo clown's a double.
They have the tall boys of them now, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Do they? I actually didn't even know that.
That was my gnarly. That was just my gnarliest shotgun.
Let's go do it. I will show you around town. I'll take you to breweries.
I'm going to tell you the last time I went to any, like, kind of little bars and shit like that, I was back in Seguin, but I had a homeboy named Josh living in Woodlands.
Yeah.
And I came out here, like, I used to always come out here and shit with him. And he'd take me down them little fucking pubs and give me fucking.
Josh what? I might know him.
Josh Scott?
No.
Such a common name.
That was his first name. Josh Scott.
He probably knows.
I know a lot of people in the Woodlands.
Josh William Scott. Three first names. Figure it out.
Is it Sean William Scott's brother?
Yeah.
There you go.
It's
a non-creative family.
We gotta get out,
though. I will take you around. I will take you. We will go to my favorite
breweries. There's a lot of good breweries in Louisiana, too.
Yes.
There are a lot of good breweries.
Bayou
Tesh
is
out there.
Bayou Tesh was going to be my number one. That's my favorite.
Bayou Tesh is great, yeah.
Nola Brewery, actually just got picked up by one of our previous episode guests. Nola Jesus Christ, I'm trying to make this touch. Taylor Gregory from Flood Independent Distribution, they just picked up
Nola
Brewery. What's up, Taylor? There's two people behind the scenes of the show that have come on the show, but do more behind the scenes just to help us out, and it's Kang and Taylor Gregory.
Jamie does a lot.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry.
Jamie's sitting right there. Jamie does a lot.
Jamie's Instacart shirt. I see that. I fucking love Instacart, by the way.
He doesn't work for them.
I don't care. I just love Instacart.
he just
I live in East Downtown. There's, like, nowhere to go grocery shopping. I use Instacart all the time.
Oh, shit.
I had never heard of it until I met
Hell, the fourth mic that used to be right where you're sitting was Jamie's microphone. He recorded two albums on it. It's not there anymore, so.
I feel privileged to be sitting in the spot where it happened.
Oh, God.
Yeah, that would be a fire track. I can see that right there. Yeah, DC and Jamie.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
I'm with it, man.
I'm listening.
I'm always putting out new music, man.
Were you trying to wrap it up?
No, go ahead.
I just wanted to say, I think the reason that your music resonates, or like why people are listening, is because in a lot of your verses, it literally just sounds like you're talking to somebody specifically. Like, there's been a couple songs where like you're addressing like, I don't know, like women type of issues, like, or like relationship style shit, and it literally sounds like you're talking to one chick specifically, but you're not.
Oh yeah.
And
or
then,
are you?
Or are
I mean,
you?
I'm not gonna lie. Like, in some of my songs, I am talking directly.
Yeah.
Like, you know.
But it still gets a universal message, which I think is what makes you, like...
Yeah, I make sure, like, you know, I make sure...
Conviction,
like,
too.
Yeah, that, too.
Conviction.
And I hope that conviction hits everybody else, because I want you to realize, you did the same shit I did.
You're not the only one going
through
this.
I'm not the only one out here.
This is the only one that says conviction.
Yeah, this fucking brew is conviction.
A conviction concoction.
For real. Because
it was made with conviction.
Conviction concoction.
So you said you already recorded one video.
That was an old Garrett. I like that one.
Do you have any other videos lined up?
Right now, I haven't really decided in which direction I'm going to go with the next video, but I'm pretty sure I'm gonna do a couple more. I want to make this EP something solid.
Yeah.
And I feel like the first single and the first video is probably my biggest investment.
Yeah.
So.
And you're dropping them both tomorrow at the same time?
I'm not going to drop the video tomorrow.
Okay.
I'm going to drop the audio. And I was hoping y'all got a chance to play it like tonight because I sent it to y'all, but we'll just whenever we do drop it, I'll send it to y'all.
No shit, I got
I was hoping you're just gonna freestyle.
He's got
right
it on.
Oh, he will freestyle. He said he won't. I didn't get your song.
I
didn't get your song. Whenever I got it, neither of anyone that was supposed to be here was here. And by the time they got back, we're here. I'm not just gonna play a song.
But
you did say you wanted to freestyle, right?
I freestyle for it.
Yeah, freestyle right now.
Awesome.
Right now.
Damn.
Right now?
All right.
Right now.
On the spot like that?
Or something. Yeah, look. It goes like, roll up, hot box. Start a house fire when I hopped out. Front row. Yo, girl. concert, bitch. You a cop block? I came from nothing to something, nigga. Back in Shady, I ain't fucking with it. Show her how the lead work. Pussy got a treadmill, how I'm running in it. Like D-Hard, like I'm prolific, smoking do-do. That's Jehovah Witness, bucket list. When I make it, I ain't faking, about to smash Oprah Winfrey. Drop it on for the game plan. Back.
Sorry.
Oh, no, that was great.
I like that one, man.
The rhythm was awesome. It's original. I like it. I like it a lot.
This is a freestyle, man.
That was good.
Like
that was great. It was awesome. It also made us laugh a little bit too.
Smash Oprah
in a good way.
Yeah, I'm sorry, we just cut through your face.
Nah, shit. I liked it, bro. I was ready to keep going.
Just in case anyone didn't hear it, DC's gonna smash Oprah Winfrey.
I would. I'd put a game plan. I will.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah. Beat that bitch with the color purple.
Oh shit.
Oh, air for the win. That was great.
Oh man. I'm sorry. I don't even know who I'm apologizing to, but I'm sorry.
I thought he was going to appreciate the value in that joke, and I just got to hand it to him. That's hilarious.
I said, tell us the color purple. Not Garrett. Watch it.
Garrett, FTW right there.
Yeah.
No, but I've decided I might be able to write like
y'all
two lines.
People, shit.
Just write, I'm gonna give people two bars at a time.
Is what he is right now.
Yeah. Two bars at a time. I'm gonna start just slinging them into people and just see how it works.
You're just gonna test them out.
Yeah, that shit would catch you though.
Get your feelers out there. You just gonna throw some feeler lines.
Yeah.
You can't just come with that. Like, just happens.
So DC, man. So for anyone that hasn't heard you yet, that is watching here today,
yeah,
what do you want to tell those people? Like why should they listen to DC?
Probably because they haven't heard me.
That's a good reason.
I'm pretty sure it's tons of fucking people who haven't heard me, but I mean, I'm talking something legitimate. Like,
yeah,
my message.
I can attest to that. Yeah,
I don't really promote violence.
Yeah,
I don't promote anything. I feel like it's not going to touch the masses. Like, if anything, I drop the shit that's going to uplift people.
Yeah.
Or make you want to, like, get on your shit. Or make you want to think outside the box. Or make you think, like, how did he think of that? But he's living here doing this. You know?
Yeah.
So, give people a higher inspiration just outside of working a 9-to-5.
Yeah.
Like, and through my music, like, I reached that. Because truth be told, I haven't been many, like, places in the world.
Yeah.
And, like, for the shit that I think about and the shit that I come up with, it's like,
you
would
think
I've been everywhere.
You think you travel?
You think I've seen it all. So, you know, I just really want people to grasp it.
Yeah.
Take the music and, you know, really, like, cherish it for what it is. Because I don't do it just because.
Yeah.
I do it for them to listen.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
You have a line that you literally, like, I don't want to fuck it up because I do that a lot.
You don't have to say do that. You just say
do.
Yeah,
doo-doo.
My English
doo-doo.
Used to say that. If you say doo-doo, your sentence
said,
is doo-doo.
Y'all make
fact.
Y'all make what they or what you think they want. You said pretty much your version of what you do is you're gonna tell the people. What
yeah,
they
I'm
need.
Not making what you
you're
want.
Like,
I'm
no,
making what you need.
You know,
shit.
You're gonna
yeah.
create a need for something because you're gonna tell them what they want.
Yeah,
exactly.
yeah.
And you got a line that was like that. I just don't want.
I know what you're
it.
Talking about. Like,
really,
the brew of heart is on me, like right now. But I know exactly what you're talking about.
But that's a law of life, though, and a law of any kind of something you're doing. Do something different, and don't do what people expect you to do. Tell them what they want.
Yeah,
exactly.
And most of the time, they're gonna want it.
That's the difference. That's the difference between someone that's trying to stay and someone that's trying to like be relevant.
Grow.
Exactly.
Yeah. Someone that's trying to stay is going to try to keep up with the current trend of music.
Yes.
And they're not telling you what you
that's
need
it.
To hear. They're telling you
yeah,
what you want
yeah,
to hear.
Yeah,
yeah.
That's it.
That
man.
Is my little Uzi vert. Sorry.
That was cute. That was really cute. I like that.
Someone needs to tell me it's cute.
Vert. But that's it, man. Like, you know, I'm not a wave rider.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, I'm a wave
setter. Wave setter.
Ah. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so would you say you're a wave setter?
I'm a wave setter, man.
Yeah.
Like, I don't want to ride the wave.
Yeah.
This is kind of wild because here we are, like, two different people,
two
different things. But,
I
was, I started out.
Damn near.
Less than a week.
Damn near.
But here we are, people that are pioneers of what we did. People told, like I said, people told me that I was, that they didn't get it. They didn't understand. They bought my shirts at first, my friends at first, when I first started. Because they wanted support.
Yeah.
Unless they were those, people, people trying to rub it,
yeah.
But they didn't understand it at all because craft beer hadn't really had its explosion in Houston.
Yeah,
and now people are starting to get it, but it doesn't matter that people didn't get it then. It was something that I knew it was going
to
be great.
Yeah.
And greatness is only what you make it.
Yeah.
So.
And then you know even that time like, they want to rep it, because they wanted to be a part of it. It's just like, you know, they wait on the pop. Yeah. They wait on you to pop. They want to have something they can tie to you.
Yeah.
You know, oh, yeah, I had a shirt before. It was cool.
Like, oh, look at this shirt.
Oh, exactly.
Ben had this shirt.
Yeah. I know the owner of this. Yeah, I know the owner of this. Yeah. It's fine. That's fine, though. You know what? If you're proud of my friend, then tell people that you're proud of me.
Yeah, exactly. Be proud.
Because if you're friends, I'm proud to be your friend.
Yeah.
Oh, you actually don't have it.
Anything you want to go out on, man?
Hey, I'll give you one that actually has my personal info on it.
I need that. I need
fancy. So no, put that. You don't need that one. It's fine.
I could be.
Throw it away. Don't even put it in your wallet. Throw it on the ground.
Just like this one, but it has my personal info. Okay. Not everyone gets that one.
I'm trying to model.
Otherwise,
I don't know. There you go.
No. It literally just is like this.
Okay, cool. It's lit.
Anything you want to go out on, DC?
Thank y'all, first of all.
Thank you.
I appreciate you coming. I appreciate you sitting next to that smelly ass man.
True.
You made a bus ride just to get here.
I did that.
Oh, yeah, that guy.
That shit. But, like I said, I want everybody to be inspired, man. Yeah. I feel like everybody has a purpose. Well, not feel like it. Everybody
has a purpose. Everybody does, yeah.
You got to fulfill your purpose. My purpose may be to make music and reach the masses.
Yeah.
You know, inspire people. And that's what I want to do.
Yeah.
That's what I'm here for. I came on that bus. Hopefully people will get the bigger picture. Like, I travel on that bus to go here to talk with y'all, be with y'all.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Have an understanding vibe with y'all.
Yeah.
That was important to me. Like, a network is important to me because you don't know who will help you and when they'll help you.
Yeah.
So, like,
networks are the best.
Yeah. Well, I feel like everybody keep an open mind. Like, man, you're positive. You know what I'm saying?
I feel that.
And fuck with that right now, tomorrow.
Yeah.
Right now.
Well, I appreciate you coming, man. I appreciate you making that trip.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what it is.
How long are you staying in the city for?
Man, I'm here to Sunday morning, so if y'all want to turn up like through the weekend, I'm
there we go.
We'll
turn up after this. We'll have a couple more beers after this.
Mm-hmm. Where's your card?
It's over there. I'll give it to you. Don't worry. Do I need to go get it? Is everyone that actually gave me my card?
Nah.
I'm just trying to link. Like I say, network is like crazy. Ain't no telling who she'll run across and be like, I know this boy in D.C., you know what I'm saying?
That's how networks work.
And I'm going to pull up.
Exactly. Especially when it's good people that you actually appreciate.
Yeah, I'm going to pull
it's
up.
Really easy to promote and talk about people that you like and know. And
that's why I love this show.
And they better not ask
because it happens naturally.
If I know anybody
who
make beer.
Yeah.
He's going
to
be like, well.
Check out the Brewheart Apparel. That's
what the ticket is first.
There you go.
Guys, this was a beautiful fucking episode.
I had a blast. You guys are awesome.
Thank you for coming.
Thanks for having
Carlos
me.
Carlos is loving his new like mic.
No, I really have to pee. I'm trying to get the fuck out of here.
You and me both.
I'm using the employee bathroom.
Damn it.
That's why they call it the employee bathroom.
I only got the privilege once.
www.southsidecollection.com for all the goods, all the podcasts, Southside Collection on Facebook, Southside Cole on Twitter.
@NDC_though.
Yeah,
Brewheart APP, Brewheart app on Twitter, Brewheart Apparel on Instagram, and Brewheart Apparel.com.
Thank you so much for watching, y'all. That I don't have to be.
Yeah.